Alright, here we are at the very top. This is the highest elevation of the trails back here. And yeah, we cut all this trail section in here. You'll see we put some high bank turns in. Allows you to carry your speed, you know, more speed through the turn. And, you know, constantly having to cut trees that fall, you know, across the trail. Leaf blow, weed whack. It's a labor of love. Here we go. All right. So, I just came from way up there. And as you can see, it was all downhill. That's the funnest part. And then I came down there. And then we're going back here. So, you'll see that we do the trails in both directions, because it increases the mileage and the diversity. And we all know diversity is key these days, right? All right. Watch out here on the right, the steep drop off. So yeah, in one direction a downhill, the other is uphill. Obviously, duh. Yeah, this is a shitty uphill. I like it better going down it. Alright, now if you were paying attention, when I came in down from the houses, I went flying down here, and then up there, to the top. Alright, here's a nice downhill. I'll be doing it later uphill. Possibly. We'll see. Stop and admire the beauty. So again, earlier we were way up there. Alright, a little bit of a rest for this old dog. Whew. If you recall, I did this the opposite direction earlier, holding true to my word, backwards and forwards. A good good thing about these trails is it's all wooded and it's all shade. So it's a lot cooler when it's warm out, like it is today, late September day. This tree got struck by lightning. This section here is really rocky and rutted up. Gotta be careful. But that's where my 7 inches of suspension, front and rear, really help out. Yeah, it's probably overkill for these trails, but I don't care. I'd rather have a plush ride and sacrifice pedaling efficiency. GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, start recording. Now this section here on the road connects the two trail endpoints. That way I can make a big loop. Yeah. this section I'm weed whacking all the time. It's nice now, as you can tell. Wow. All right, I gotta rest. But and if you noticed, there are a bunch of wooden pallets. We put those down because that section is always wet all year round. There's like an underground stream or something. So we put some chicken wire fencing over top to give it some grip. It works really well. Here's one of the many trees I had to cut with the chainsaw. There was one back there, big one. Anyway, we're gonna go way up there once again. It's a shitty long climb. Sometimes I just don't feel like riding a mountain bike, but I kind of think of it as an investment in my health equity. You know, kind of like house equity, you build wealth. Yet another tree I had to cut. Now this trail is when I first started on the video, came flying down from the houses. Now of course I don't have all that momentum. I am so freaking out of shape. Oh, shit. So, I can barely talk. So anyway, we cut in these two paths. Take a guess why. Going uphill, you take this one. Going back down, which I have not done yet on this video, you go straight on that one. So you don't have to lose your speed and your momentum. Pretty clever. So, GoPro, start recording. GoPro, start recording. GoPro, turn off. GoPro, start recording. This tree took me 3 hours on a cold January day to clear. All right. through those wooden pallets I was telling you about. Not sure if I have the energy to do this next climb. It's short, but very steep. Oh. Like a motherfucking boss. Almost done. surprised this bridge has stood all these years. You can see here, the horses like to eat it. That's how that come about. So anyway, we've been on the very top a couple times so far. That's way up there. This is the last section where we connected it. It's a little sketchy, but as you can see, we used the big logs as, you know, reinforcements, steel rebar. It's good, it works. It works. All right. Yeah, my tank is pretty much close to empty. So I just gotta push to finish. Yeah, so I'm gonna finish the ride by, I can't even fucking talk. By going down there, up and then back this way. And then all the way back to the top in reverse direction, back up to the houses. Yeah. Definitely don't want to fall here. You can see the high bank turn here. And here's another one. It's not as inclined anymore, but it still helps. Yeah, you can see where we cut all this in, you know. Basically, we're just hand tools. Pain in the ass, but nobody else is gonna do it. Oh, one more shitty ass climb to the very top. We've done that twice so far, but coming in the opposite direction. So now, the third time at the top, with this configuration I'm doing today, takes you up this way. Oh my gosh. Problem is, I don't do this consistent enough because I don't have the time. All right. Yeah, we try to remove all the rocks here, but there's so many of them. That we just left them in here, you can see. There's a dead tree here that I cut down right here to the left. Ah. Oh, shit. A couple years ago. And then I cut it up and lined the trail with it. You know, just another little personalization. I think it makes the trails nicer. All right, final descent. I'm gonna go down here, over there, over that section, that straight, back down to the houses. See, look at this, I don't even have to pedal. Perfect. Oh my God, that breeze feels so good. GoPro, stop recording.